Welcome to Top 10 USA, home of the rocket platform. Please follow our replacement procedures and be sure to use appropriate ESD standards and techniques throughout the replacement process. If these procedures are not followed appropriately, damage to your SAN as well as data loss may occur. If your machine is covered under the Rocket Plus subscription and you have any questions or concerns, please open a ticket through the Rocket Platform customer portal. Your first step is to access the group manager of your Dell EqualLogic array. There are two methods to accessing your array. If you already know how to access the Dell EqualLogic Group Manager, please skip to 1 minute and 9 seconds. If you are utilizing SAN Headquarters, you will want to launch the SAN Headquarters client. Once SAN Headquarters is loaded, on the left-hand side of the page, you will see a list of current groups managed by SAN Headquarters. From here, you will need to select on the particular group with the current issue. You will right-click on the group name and select the option Launch Group Manager and log in using your login credentials. If you are accessing your Dell EqualLogic via web browser, you will open your preferred web browser and in the address bar either enter the host name of your SAN or the management IP address. Once you see a login prompt, please enter your login credentials. Now that you are logged into the EqualLogic Group Manager, you are going to need to identify the EqualLogic array with the issue. On the left-hand side of the page, we are going to select on the particular array that currently has an indicator marking. In the center of the screen, you will see a row of tabs across the top of the page. You will need to go to the Maintenance tab of the Dell EqualLogic array. To the right-hand side of the page, you're going to see a section of identification information of this array. Be sure to click Start LEDs Flashing, and then make note of the service tag of your Dell EqualLogic array. We will need the service tag and any LED indication turned on for any service procedure in order to identify the faulty SAN with ease. If either of these methods do not work or the machine is inaccessible, contact us directly. When replacing a control module in a Dell EqualLogic array, you will need to first identify through the group manager which control module is currently failed and ensure it is in either the secondary state or the not installed state. For you to identify the failed control module, you will go under the Controllers tab in the group manager. From the Controllers tab, we can see the information regarding the control modules that are currently installed. The control modules will be in one of three states: active, secondary, and not installed. The not installed state will only be displayed if the controller cannot boot or the no controller is currently installed. If the control module is in either the secondary or not installed state, then it is safe to proceed with replacing the faulty controller. Please skip to 3 minutes and 18 seconds. If the control module is in the active state, you will need to force it into the secondary state. During a period of low IOs or off hours, log into the group manager. Select a member with the faulty control module and navigate to the Maintenance tab. Under the Maintenance tab, select the option Restart. After selecting the option, you will be prompted to input the management password. Once the password has been accepted, the system will restart the active control module, causing the secondary control module to take the active role. You must now wait for the faulty control module to reboot and show in the secondary state within the Controllers tab. If the controller fails to come online within an hour of waiting, the controller has failed to boot and is safe to replace. Now that you have identified which control module has failed and ensured it is ready for replacement, you will need to identify the position of the control module. Navigate to the Status tab. From the Status tab, we can see a graphical representation of the front of the array on the left-hand side of the tab. Above this graphic, select the Rear View option. This will change the view of the graphic to the rear of the array, allowing you to identify the position of the failed control module. As you see here, controller in slot 1 is in the bottom slot in the rear of the array. Using the LED indication you had turned on, locate the array. The array should have every indication light on the machine flashing. Verify that this is the correct array using the service tag from the group manager. The service tag of the array should be located on a sticker in the rear of the machine by the controller slots. Once the array has been identified, you will need to turn off the indicator lights. Enter into the group manager and select a member with the failed control module. Open up the Maintenance tab and on the right hand side select the option Stop LEDs Flashing. In the rear of the machine you will see the control modules. If the faulty control module is in the secondary state now, it will have a green light for the PWR and an amber light for the ACCT. If the control module is in the not installed state, the controller will have a green light for the PWR and a red light for the ERR. The PWR light indicates whether or not the control module is receiving power. The ACCT light indicates whether the controller is active, green, or secondary, amber. The ERR light will light up red to indicate an error within the controller during the boot process. Confirm the control module with default matches what was seen in the status tab of the group manager. Once you have confirmed which of the control modules are faulted, label the network cables and according to how they are currently oriented. After you have labeled your cables, remove them from the ports. You will see an orange tab with a small black lever behind it. Push down on the orange tab and swing the lever outwards. Once the lever is fully opened, you will be able to pull the control module straight back until the controller has been fully removed from the array. You must now move the SD card from the faulty controller to the replacement controller. In the rear of the faulty controller, you will see the SD and the SD card slot. Push in on the SD card, releasing the locking mechanism. Pinch on the card and pull it straight back out of the slot. On the replacement controller, push the SD card into the slot until you hear it or see it click into place. Once the SD is clicked into place, you are safe to insert the replacement controller. Open the lever all the way on the replacement controller, then insert it into the slot. Once seated in around 90% of the way, the lever on the controller will begin to catch. Once the lever begins to catch, push the lever inwards until you see or hear the orange tab click into place. Attempt to pull backwards on the controller without releasing the locking mechanism. If the controller stays in the place, then the control module has been properly seated. If the controller moves in the slot, then you must reseat the controller. Attach the cables according to how you labeled them. Return to the group manager and confirm that the control module is now showing healthy. If the array is now back to a healthy status, you are safe to close this call out. If the control module fails to come back online or other issues arise, please contact us directly. Thank you for choosing the Rocket Platform, the evolution in hardware maintenance.
Thanks for watching. This has been another video by the Top 10 USA Video Production Team. We look forward to sharing more content with you going forward, so please check out our YouTube channel and please subscribe so that you get notified whenever we release a new piece of content.